Hey summoners, and welcome to my high elo AP Elisa Meet commentary, made by me, Hippodix. As for tradition, we're going to look the optimal setup for release, then quick rappel tutorial, followed by with the commentary, and in the end the credits. Hope you enjoy. For runes, I recommend magic penetration marks, armor seals, magic resist glyphs, and flat ability power quintessences. For masteries, take 2190, getting all the damage goodies from defense tree and 9 points in defense for extra sustain. These rules and masters combined makes your Elise play really aggressive early on, while being able to sustain some pressure as well. For skill leveling up, prioritize Neurotoxin / Venomous Bite by level 9, then Volatile Spiderling / Kittering Frenzy by level 13, and last, Cocoon / Rappel. And traditionally, take points on Spider / Human form at level 6, 11, and 16. For items, start up with either boots and 3 health potions, or crystalline flask and some pots thrown together. Some people dislike the flask due to its higher price today, but I think it's still more than viable item. Therefore, core build up the Sorcerer's Shoes, Haunting Guise, and Zonia's Hourglass. For boots enhancement, the one and only Home Guard boots. Situationally, build up items such as Doran's Ring, Lyndrin's Torment, Rabadon's Deathcap, or Ryla's Crystal Scepter. I've tried couple times rushing Tier and Elise, and indeed it is easy to build up the mana since you don't have mana costs in Spider form. However, I think it just delays the items you honestly will going to be needed, and therefore I'm not suggesting Archangel staff at all. And for summoner spells, Flash and Ignite. I've honestly had only really bad issues against Syndra in mid lane, as Elise, so if this matchup happens, I'd suggest to take Barrier instead. Here you can see me clicking into empty space, and therefore Elise rappels into the air, doing nothing and coming back to its place after 2.5 seconds. In this example, Elise rappels into the air until he clicks enemy target and get next to that once clicked. You can also rappel into someone by just pressing E and moving the cursor around target. And the final most important note about Rappel is that you can actually net yourself into jungle creeps, even without you having vision on them. This trick can prevent you using flash very effectively. Alright, as we move into the game, you can see I'm laning against Cassiopeia this game. And for jungler we have Bunkis playing on Maokai, for bot lane we got Graves and Taric, and top we got Singed. And their top is Irelia, jungle with on Xintao, and their bot lane is going to be Sivir and Leona. So pretty nice picks overall. I really like them. Alright. Nothing special gonna happen here. They're gonna defend their blue, and we're gonna defend this red. Maokai is gonna start. Actually, he is going for the blue. Even though the bot lane, we're on the blue side. So I'd recommend, if you are on this side, to start up the jungle from the red buff, even if it's Maokai, because you can get smiteless from the bot lane. But this is not a bad option either. I just prefer otherwise. He's gonna put those thingies there, and I'm gonna help him using my spider form. And as you can see, since there is no cost in spider form, it's better to use it to help this one out. And here comes the pull. Look at this. The spiders actually tank some of it, which gives a good advantage for the jungler, even taking him the less damage there. So it's very recommended to use that spider form's Q, because you can make it over that wall. So Cassiopeia is similar to Syndra, but not as annoying. She will have that Q, she has that good teasing potential, but you just gotta be careful. As I already took 2 Qs from Cassio, it is pretty annoying indeed. There comes my Q to counter poke, and swapping instantly to spider form, making some more damage. But I'm actually taking more damage than him currently, as I wasn't aware of his goodness in this lane. But moving on to level 2, I pick up the rabble now. Irelia's gonna disconnect for some reason. I have no explanation for that. The lane will get pushed a little in favor of Cassiopeia's here. As the bot lane went to AFK, Graves is gonna pick up the first blood, and here comes the Maokai. Beautiful route there. I'm gonna fail that cocoon because the minion was away, but since Elise damage is just too good, it doesn't gonna matter, and we'll pick up the easy kill for Cassiopeia. So it's 2-0 for our team. Pretty good start indeed. As Irelia is AFK, Xinchao has to force him way up to the top lane, which is bad, really bad for them. And now once you've got the kill, you want to push the lane immediately. And as I was very low HP, I want to return at this point. Irelia is gonna reconnect back. And this is good time to explain the fact that you have to use spider form every time you travel, because you will get extra movement speed out of it. So whenever you are traveling towards the lane or ganking other lanes, then it is very recommended to use the spider form. It's pretty similar to Nidalee, how she has the base movement speed and that Cogger leap once she's at that form, so it's very good. So I got a Doran's Ring from the base and doing pretty good damage up to Cassio. We're at same level now, but as you can see, that damage gonna make some pressure. I'm gonna miss the stun again, but it doesn't matter, this damage is just too freaking good, and Elise will pick up the second kill on Cassiopeia there. So even though I failed second time my cocoon, it doesn't matter, this is already one lane by Elise, because the trading amount you just did is marvelous. Holy crap. Since you're gonna recall back to top lane, it is in favor of him because Irelia disconnected, as well as bot lane is doing pretty good, making that pressure on towards the turret, Graves having that one kill, as well as Taric. As I didn't push it fast enough, Cassio's gonna come back. Since I don't wanna go back myself, I decided not to push the lane at this point. Going back to human form now, gonna try to poke some it, and you look at that damage! Holy crap, it is really doing good damage. On that third rank of neurotoxin, it is very, very pressuring this one hard. Cassiopeia trying to make some more poke, but I'm starting to learn the pattern how she are throwing these, so I can actually try to dodge these more. And as I got the boots, it is a lot easier to dodge them. Xinchao here, trying to gank for this Cassiopeia. I'm sending my spider. As you can see, the spiders are following pretty well on the enemy champions, if there aren't enough close range there. Xinchao's going to come for gank, as I'm not aware of this. I'm gonna go in, gonna rappel into that minion, and just denying Xinchao's presence overall, that he doesn't even charge on me. Trying to zone out this Cassiopeia more, gonna send out another spider, doing decent damage for level 1. We are aware of this Xinchao here. As we had no vision, we knew he's gonna go on the raids. But nothing is going to happen. As you can see, Cassiopeia is again very low HP. There comes the spider, and Cocoon's gonna miss again. So there's not gonna be kill traded at this point. Xinchao's gonna back up the lane. Cassiopeia going back again. Looking down towards creeps, they are pretty much same, but I am on the clear edge. Definitely. So Xinchao here in this mid lane, Maokai doing maybe some counter jungling. We'll try to gank this Irelia. Xinch doing good poison bait there. There comes the flash, which followed up spells by Maokai. It's not going to be enough. Punk is pretty low mana there, so not going to be kill traded. Sending some more spiders towards Cassio. As she just got level 6, I'm at level 7 already, so pretty good looking towards us. We're gonna pick up this blue buff. We're gonna rappel in. And there we go. Going back to this lane. just in time, so I won't miss that many creeps around. And once you're under the turret, it is wise to use your spider form abilities. And in overall, whenever you can use the spider form, just use the abilities, because they will cost no mana. Leona going in with a Cassiopeia's gank. There comes Cassiopeia's ult, will not stun, will just slow Taric. And Grave's gonna pick up the kill on Leona there. But Taric is going to die as well. As well as Sivir almost going to die. I'm gonna ignore Cassiopeia and wanted to push this mid lane some more. Even though lots of pings coming there. Actually gonna care a bit now. Gonna notice this Cassiopeia. There comes the flash stun. She's gonna flash as well. So she won't get rappled immediately. Really reflexed play there by Cassiopeia. As you can see, she is already scared of me. As I got only 2 kills. Cassiopeia is going to get back, so I'm gonna go back to the lane. Gonna push down this lane using my spider form. As you can see, the mini spiders are all also hitting this one. And there comes the full burst again. Cassiopeia back in the lane, having no chance at all. Sorry for the fast skipping there. I wasn't aware I killed him that fast. I can't remember all the details. But as you can see, she had no chance against me, and I'm picking to kill instantaneously on Cassiopeia. So it's 3 kills for me and 0 kills for her, as she has 3 deaths. We're gonna pick up the Drake. Maka is gonna smite it. And Leona is gonna flash away, knowing that she will die if he's not gonna do anything. As I'm aware of this Xin Zhao, there comes the stun, there comes the Q, another Q from the spider form. She's gonna do those strong auto attacks, but will it be available? I'm gonna pick up the kill on Xin Zhao, but the red buff is gonna finish me down. Getting that bonus card from Xin Zhao, but will die as well. As I wanted to go back already, it doesn't matter, and I think it was just fine, as we're doing pretty well overall. She's doing pretty okay, as well as the bot lane. No complaints. So I'm back at this lane. I've got my Hope Guard boots already, because I really love them, trust me. And also the Haunting guys, and I just put a ward there in case of Xin Zhao is coming. So even though I have only 80 ability power, it is doing a strong damage indeed. And Cassiopeia at the same time, on this bot lane again, gonna do those ganks. As Xin Zhao covering the mid, I'm gonna pressure down this mid and ignoring the bot lane again. As I prefer to stay in the lane and then roaming around. Because I know that I can trade Cassiopeia very easily. So instead of leaving the lane, I wanted to snowball it, but they don't have much vision in the bot lane, so it's their own fault if they're dying there. Xin Zhao's gonna charge in. Gonna back off a little. Is he gonna put me in air? Actually not. Running towards this brush. Cassiopeia and Leona coming. So I'm a little aware of this, as we have the pink ward in the... There. There comes the W. Gonna miss on Cassio. Doing some pressure on the minions. Leona and Xin Zhao gonna roam this one up. There they will come. And I'm gonna rappel away towards the creeps. There comes the Leona's ult. I'm gonna get slowed. And Maokai's gonna jump in. Actually trying to bait for this Maokai, but it doesn't gonna cost us well. Because I'm gonna get died by hands of Cassiopeia. And she will pick up the second kill for her. So we're actually getting a little backtracked here now. As we had a clear advantage in the early game. Cassiopeia gonna pick up that blue for the top lane, since she's leading on creeps, because I really was disconnected. Having pretty nice items already. Doing some flings there. For the bottom lane, it is leading. Graves, about 20 CS leading there as well. But both Sivir and Graves have 2 kills, so their body's not doing bad either. Using my spider form again, getting back to this lane. Gonna clear down some creeps. About the mini spiders, I wanted to say. Never mind. There comes the Cassiopeia ultimate. I'm gonna flash in, and she's gonna use flash as well. I wanted to hit that cocoon, but the minions were blocking it, so that's a disadvantage in the lane, that the minions can block your stun. So about the mini spiders, you can use your mini spiders to pull the buffs, like I just did in early, and they also do damage to the turrets, and once you use your W in spider form, where you gain tons of attack speed, it will apply to the mini spiders as well, so you get a lot of pushing potential as well on Elise, so it is truly a great champion. And about the patch, this is after the first nerf came to Elise, which reduced his some damage output, not after the 3.04 patch, where they're gonna increase the damage on spider form, but they're going to reduce the damage on human form, making it more risky play on Elise. So this is in the middle patch, middle nerf patch, you could say. Putting some more pressure, doing tons of damage. Look at that shit. It really does hurt, that neurotoxin damage. So I'm not surprised it's going to get nerfed. Sooner or later. Sivir gonna pick his third kill there. As I'm in the mid lane, they're gonna pick up the kill on Taric as well. Xinjiao is gonna pick up that kill. Gonna push down this turret sooner or later. So we're at the equal on the kills, but we're at the gold lead still, so we haven't lost the edge yet. She's doing some raids. As the lane is pushed, he doesn't want to get risked. And there comes the double roam again. They're really starting to hate me, as I already got 4 kills. They are aware of that I'm a good Elise player. And there comes the Cassiopeia stun. Leona ultimate coming up. Leona jumping in on this singed. Maokai going in. Leona putting on exhaust, but it's not gonna be enough to finish this one up. So Maokai is gonna get killed by Cassio, and I'm gonna finish up this Leona. Gonna stun this Xinjiao. And actually, he's going to get away with very low HP with Cassiopeia. Too unfortunate. Putting some more spider pressure. It's gonna follow the Sivir. Nothing special gonna happen there. Gonna clear this one up. Gonna clear this mid lane. Putting some more spiders up to move. Gonna push down this lane some more. Going back to base. So I got 2 Doran's rings now for extra sustain, as the other champions are putting good pressure on me. It's good to have some Doran's rings backed up if you think you need a little bit more sustain. And I really like the Doran's items, because you get some AP as well. Same goes for Doran's. Doran's blade, you get some extra damage, and they're pretty good in laning phase. And I also have the needlessly large run at this point, so I'm really doing good. As I'm leading 30 CS and 2 kills, so I'm really doing myself good. As the team is collapsing a little, we're gonna pick up the second Drake. Taric is actually not going to stun this one. I don't know what is the reasoning for this. I believe we had a chat conversation up to this, that why the hell you didn't stun this Leona. So I don't know, maybe he's on drugs or something, who knows. Making some pressure, there comes the Maokai stun. Leona ultimate gonna cover up for this. Not gonna rappel towards Irelia, it will be too greedy. Too greedy indeed. Singed gonna go in. Gonna use that ghost, will fling up Irelia, followed up by Punky stun there. Cassiopeia is gonna stun us. It's really crowded mess. I'm gonna force down this Sivir from the fight, because he's pretty strong. Making some dual up to him. She's trying to kill me, I'm flashing to this brush, stunning him and holy crap, really close one. Gonna survive on that, as they're fighting Xinjiao out there, and we will ace them with that splitting fight. Holy crap, that was really crazy. Crazy indeed. As I couldn't fight Sivir head to head, because Sivir has strong auto attacks when she has that blade of the mainstream king and some attack damage put into it. I baited I baited basically herself into this brush, stunned him and got the advantage there, as she had no vision over me, so that's how you turn things around. And that rappel was for nothing, basically. So just wanted to make sure I don't die, because it was really, really tempting fight there. Gonna clear some creeps here. Almost up to 150 CS. Gonna finish up that Sonya's Hourglass, as I have already the early bought Hunting Guys and Sorcerer's Shoes with Home Guard upgrade. Sinch gonna get killed by this jungler and Irelia as they're pushing this mid. I'm doing some side pressure and look at that damage! Just with the W and Q, I'm doing up to 55% of Sivir's HP pool. Looking down to Sivir, she has only 44 magic resist, but she has that spell shield, so she is definitely very, very squishy one. Will take lots of damage from me. Only thing he can use for survivability is that he's going to be that spell shield. So you just saw how good pressure you can do even without rushing Rabadon's. The reason I really like this Hourglass, because you get a 2.5-second immunity with that, and once you Divine Rappel with that, it is up to 5 seconds of immunity you can put up with at least. That is insane. Gonna miss that stun, still regardless going in, putting some pressure. Sinch are gonna use his Solari. Will fail that kill, because I missed the stun. Sometimes really having some problems with the cocoon, because players are starting to realize how easy it is to dodge. So it requires some trial and error. Same goes for the rappel, that you can rappel through these neutral waves even when you don't have vision, as I explained in the rappel tutorial. But it's very, very useful. I definitely recommend it for all Elise players. Gonna put that spider poking some damage out. We're gonna try to push this top lane. We have all the players here. Sivir is in bot, so it's 4 vs 5. Sinch gonna go in. Cassiopeia gonna go thrown instantly. Sinch putting pressure with that poison. Maokai's gonna throw that ultimate. We're going to pick up only one kill there as we're trying to push down this top lane. The minion's gonna come now. Graves is actually gonna go back to defend this bot lane as Sivir is gonna push down this top bottom at the same time. Irelia getting little cornered here, getting really hurt by her hands. I'm gonna pick up the kill, rappel towards the Leona, trying to make some pressure up, but it's not going to be enough because I will get exhausted. But it doesn't matter, I'm gonna pick up the kill on Xin Zhao thanks to that Taric stun. We're gonna force down this top turret, trying to get this inhibitor turret down, getting little poked by Cassio there. And not seeming that wise advice, we're gonna head back. So we're not gonna get this turret pushed. Cassiopeia is gonna defend it. As well as Graves is pushing the bottom lane at the same time. Doing a little counter push there, because Sivir really changed the lane there. And for the gold gaining here, we are leading now pretty well. About 7,000 gold now, so we're really, really step ahead. Going to finish up this Lyandra's Torment now, and having 8 kills and 2 deaths, it is just very, very scary damage indeed incoming from me. And for the beginners who are wondering how should I rotate my elite spells, well, you're gonna start up with the human form, because you deal more damage when the enemy has more HP up. And when you're at the spider form, you do. And an easy kill comes there. Cassiopeia is gonna stun. Not gonna stop me from chasing. Gonna rappel straight to this Cassiopeia. Maokai gonna flash root this one up. Gonna pick up the kill on Cassiopeia. Trying to do some more damage in spider form, but not gonna be enough. I really am getting a little caught here. Doing some bad plays. Trying to DPS. There comes the Zhonya's Hourglass. Gonna almost die, but going to use that rappel and flash away. As you can see, I actually survived that horrible burst. coming from that Xinjiang and RLA together, thanks to that 5-second immunity that is just freaking overpowered, if you ask me. So, sorry, I'm getting lost on track here. As I was saying about how do you rotate the spells, well, first, you use your human form spells because you do more damage when the enemy has more HP. And once you've got your QWE, then you swap instantly to the spider form and you rotate all of your spells. Q in and W for attack speed. If some threat comes in, just rappel away or rappel towards the target if he's flashing away. It's very situation dependent. But always try to start in human form, that's preferred way. I've seen some melee players starting up when they're like going on in with a rappel or something like that. That is just bullcrap, and it's not as effective as when you start up in human form. As you have seen here, I've done the rotation pretty much every time correctly, if not every time. Clearing some creeps, getting some items in. Actually, since I'm doing pretty well, I'm gonna rush that Rabadon's death cap. Having almost 400 ability power at this point, it is indeed a great source of damage coming up. As you can see, it is, yeah, fast forwarded, but you can really clear that camp fast. Gonna miss that stun, but it doesn't matter. This Leona is too freaking scared. He is going to flash away, still regardless that I miss my rappel. I'm at level 17 as Cassiopeia is level 14 and the top laners are level 15 and 16. So I'm in the levels ahead as well. Well, it's pretty easy. But no, actually, this Graves is 18 already. That's Sia's amount. I was thinking, yeah, this Graves got actually ahead of me. So he has really done some creeps along there. Sorry, I didn't notice Graves at that point, as their AD is level 15. So we are pressuring all of these lanes, trying to force inhibitor down. As we got the ward there, we have some vision over there. Graves doing a good chunk of damage to this Cassiopeia, almost getting killed. If Graves would be aware of how squishy this guy is, he would use collateral damage at that point most likely, and we would got the kill on Cassiopeia. But he wasn't aware of that squishiness and didn't use it. Xinjiang's gonna charge in. Graves gonna quick draw away. There comes Leona's ult followed up. And Cassiopeia's done. But they are really lacking damage. As we are picking the kill on Cassiopeia there, she's gonna run down and pick the kill on Xinjiang. As Graves is gonna pick up the kill on Leona. Maokai gonna go in. Little mad there. Kind of greedy place. But it doesn't matter. This damage is just freaking broken, yo! Even though I'm a huge Elise fan and this is my most played champion in Season 3 in my main and second most played in my Smurf account, I'm still happy that Elise is getting nerfed on her human form. Because I think players who play AP Elise are getting little less to value on the human form. On the spider form, sorry. So I think it's very great that the nerf is coming on human form. As you can see, it's pretty strong. And we got the game pretty fastly turned around. And there is the game. Pretty short this time, but man, that Elise is just freaking OP, if you ask me. So good damage overall, so much survivability, and decent sustain. I really recommend Elise. If you haven't tried her yet, You just saw how OP she is in mid lane. You can do that same setup in top lane if you prefer to. But I prefer mid lane as I'm mid player, so go for it. Alright, so that's about it for this time. Hope you enjoyed. After the editing process, I really noticed that I referred female champions as guy or him. So sorry about the little mistakes here and there. If you liked this commentary, please like, share and make a comment below what you think. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe to my League of Legends YouTube channel for weekly League of Legends videos to come. My name is Hopodix and have a nice free Elo with Elise.